In a parallel circuit, each resistor or device is placed in its own separate branch. The presence of branch lines means that there are multiple pathways by which a charge can traverse the external circuit. Each charge passing through the loop of the external circuit will pass through a single resistor present in a single branch. When arriving at the branching location or node, a charge makes a choice as to which branch to travel through on its journey back to the low potential terminal. Charges are divided into separate branches such that there can be more current in one branch than there is in another branch. Nonetheless, when taken as a whole, the total amount of current in all the branches when added together is the same as the amount of current at locations outside the branches. The rule that current everywhere is the same still works, only with a twist. The current outside the branches is the same as the sum of the currents in the individual branches. It is still the same amount of current, only split up into more than one pathway. This can be summarized in the form of equation I total is equal to I1 plus I2, where I total is the total amount of current outside the branches and in the battery. And I1, I2, I3 and so on represent the current in individual branches of the circuit. The diagram displays two resistors in parallel with nodes at point A and point B. Charge flows into point A at the rate of 6 amps and divides into two pathways, one through resistor 1 and the other through resistor 2. The current in the branch with resistor 1 is 4 amps and the current in the branch with resistor 2 is 8 amps. After these two branches meet again at point B to form a single line, the current again becomes 12 amps. Thus, we see the principle that the current outside the branches is equal to the sum of the current in each individual branch. I total is equal to I1 plus I2. 12 amps is equal to 4 amps plus 8 amps. The equivalent resistance of a circuit is the amount of resistance that a single resistor would need in order to equal the overall effect of the collection of resistors that are present in the circuit. For parallel circuits, the mathematical formula for computing the equivalent resistance, that is Req, is 1 divided by Req is equal to 1 upon R1 plus 1 upon R2, where R1 and R2 are the resistance values of the individual resistors that are connected in parallel. Two resistors are placed in parallel branches, each having the resistance values of 6 ohm and 3 ohm respectively. Flow of charge is proportional to the resistance offered by individual branch. Branch with resistance of 3 ohm carries more charge, 8 amperes, while the branch with 6 ohm resistance carries less charge, 4 amperes. The equivalent resistance as per the equation is 2 ohm. The current in the circuit is still 12 amperes. Voltage drop. A charge does not pass through every resistor. Rather, it passes through a single resistor. Thus, the entire voltage drop across that resistor must match the battery voltage. It does not matter whether the charge passes through resistor 1, resistor 2. The voltage drop across the resistor that it chooses to pass through must equal the voltage of the battery. Put in an equation form, this principle would be expressed as V battery is equal to V1 is equal to V2. If three resistors are placed in parallel branches and powered by a 24 volt battery, then the voltage drop across each one of the three resistors is 24 volts. A charge flowing through the circuit would only encounter one of these three resistors and thus encounter a single voltage drop of 24 volts. An electric potential diagram is a conceptual tool for representing the electric potential difference between several points on an electric circuit. Consider the circuit diagram and its corresponding electric potential diagram. As shown in the electric potential diagram, positions A, B, D are all at a high electric potential. A single charge chooses only one of the two possible pathways. Thus, at position B, a single charge will move towards point C. It then passes through the resistor that is in that branch. The charge does not lose its high potential until it passes through the resistor. Once it passes through the resistor, the charge has returned to nearly 0 volt and returns to the negative terminal of the battery to obtain its voltage boost. Unlike in series circuits, a charge in parallel circuit encounters a single voltage drop during its path through the electrical circuit. We explored series and parallel circuits using simulation and understood the behavior of charge as it travels through the internal and the external circuit.